video, dude, this shit was fucking exposed.
I got about 2 or 3, but I embraced it.
I know it was because I watched it before and I edited it. That bitch won't leave me alone. It's still there and I don't like it. I don't fuck with it. So I'm putting the camera here because when I go like this, yeah, you can see it, but you know, I'm just like, no, we're not doing it. We're not doing it. Y'all, I am feeling this hairstyle. Next one on lasts for 3 years. I just decided I never do my hair. I'll curl it or straight iron it whenever I do my hair. But this look is a look. I don't know what kind of look I want to do. Let's see. I want to go with the flow. So we're going to start off by doing our eyebrows. The curls kind of get in the way. I'm not, that's why, like, it looks cute, these hairstyles, but that's why I don't really ever do it, because they fucking get in the way. Just like in the last video, we're going to go in with this Infallible L'Oreal Paris Full Wear in the shade 355 Vanilla. And this is what we're going to use to carve. We're going to go ahead and blend these in now. Well, when I blend it in, also, just dab, not fucking really, honestly, stab it, but just, you know, push the product into your eyelid, but go all around. With the beauty blender, I feel like it takes away the product. I haven't been using beauty blenders as much anymore. Actually, I don't even use beauty blenders anymore, to be honest. This is the palette that we're going to go ahead and go into. The Jaclyn Hill Volume 2. But we're going to go ahead with an orange tone, or more of a nude tone, for our transition color. We're going to go ahead and with the Morphe brush, M14, and go in with this color right here. This is the color Feeling Myself. And add this eyeshadow right here. Stay in touch. Love you. Like on the brow bone, on the brown bone, literally. We're blending this out with the Morphe M504 brush. This is how the brush looks like, really fluffy and thick. And I like to just go ahead and go back and just blend. We're gonna go in with this color right here. It's called Thick Skin. Put it on the, we want it to still show once we cut the cut crease. Put it on the eyebrow bone, but right below it. You know what I mean, the orange? And you're just gonna dab it in there. Like so. And you're just gonna keep building it up. So see how it's just a line and it's not blended? We're just gonna go ahead and go like this. And I sometimes like to just like raise my eyebrow so that I could really get it where I want it. I'm building it up. I haven't really blended it that well. Besides this, how harsh it is. See how harsh it is, and you can tell that it's not blended, and it's, that's why I put in the eyeshadow. Well, with this brush right here, not here, but here, not where you put it at, but like a little bit above it to where it stops, you kind of just want to get your brush and just kind of like, you can drag it down too if you want. Kind of go like this, dragging it down. But also moving it. Every time I've gone to kind of blend it. Lighthouse, there's been activity. And it's never circles, the same though. Thing. We're gonna go in with the concealer again that I always use for makeup, looks. And this is what we're gonna use to carve. Put the concealer on my eyelid, and I just kind of like looked up. And see how it kind of like already creates it for you? So you're gonna go in with this brush, and you're just gonna make it a slight clean line. What I like to do is I like to add the concealer like right along the eyelid, like right next to my eyelashes. And whenever you're done cutting the crease on the eyelid, you just kind of want to pat it in. On my eyelids, I kind of want to make this like a natural yet popping kind of look. Go in with this color for the eyelid, and it's called Certified. And we are going to go in with a brush like this, an angled brush. See, this is like the inner corner to help, and then we're just going to build up the cut crease. Just dab it all over the eyelid. We're going to go back in with Thick Skin. Just dab it on here, literally just dab it in, and then just kind of blend it in. Drag in the product. Like so.
Y'all went on Scav and Reserve, bro?
So if it's not like blending out really good, just get a big fluffy brush, a blending fluffy brush, and just kind of blend it in.
We've had a lot of our housekeepers and front desk staff and late night staff have experiences to the point where they won't go into certain rooms. It's to the point where our employees are almost fearful. The experiences that we're having,
we're just gonna
could be linked to the cemetery here on property.
We'll do
the old cemetery from the early 1800s, and we feel that that's probably a strong reason why things are taking place. It's our family business. We have no choice but to kind of find out what's happening.
Kids are roaming the property as fast as possible. Now this is how it's gonna look after.
Now the church itself burned down a long time ago under mysterious circumstances.
I understand it might not be where they know the activities that were from. So I'm probably gonna have to.
Yeah.
These angled brushes really do help with like liner. And use the concealer, the same one. Dab it in there. So what we're gonna do is just line it up with a concealer.
I remember she had curly, like light grayish hair.
Just keep going with it.
Did you just say seven-figure welfare check? What is wrong with you? I fucking wish.
We get 6 figures. We're going to use a new piece of equipment to help aid us in capturing EVP. And what that is a binaural microphone.
We're going to go ahead with this neon yellow.
You got a plan in mind?
Yeah, here's my idea. Brandon Mustafa, cemetery.
Sure.
Ryan Rochelle, at cabin 13. Grant, Kristen, and myself will hit the actual restaurant.
Yeah, sure.
So we're gonna go ahead and create a wing eyeliner with this because it's, you know, the same point, liquidy. It's not really liquidy, but you know, I feel like you can maneuver this around more. So let's go ahead and try this. Just continue building it up and using the concealer to draw the eyeliner.
Times that it's going off and nobody's been in the building.
They have no reason why it should be going off.
We have no idea.
But what's strange is that our investigators
can find out in the shell when it's...
with this Benefit Bad Gal Bang mascara. I really like this mascara because of the brush. It really separates your your eyelashes.
Coronavirus.
So now, who is she? Who are you? But when you take off that makeup, it really humbles you real quick. So let's not talk shit before we throw you inside the motherfucking pool, bitch.
And
Okay. For my everyday foundation, I don't like to go in with like Too Faced foundations. I don't like to go in with them, especially if I'm just gonna be here at the house, which makes no fucking sense. Anyways, I'm gonna go with the, you know what I kind of noticed too, that L'Oreal Infallible like has a foundation and has a concealer and a foundation, so I think that was kind of pretty cool. But anyways, this is the foundation that we're going to go in with. Where is it at? This is the foundation that we're going to go in with. Then Infallible Full Wear. And I like this foundation because even when I smile, I laugh, I like, you know, and I talk a lot. So I kind of like to use this because my smiling crease shit doesn't pop out or notice. Because that's what happens a lot with a lot of my foundations. You don't notice that. Anyways, I'm in the shade of 445, and yeah, no, let's get started.
It's wild though, because like, I mean, you could obviously take some. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah, we're gonna put it a little bit.
I might start doing that. No, I don't can't. Really you can't. That's, need that's some of my. That's why people don't take a lot of.
Cash. I don't need no. Got one dot. What's one dot gonna do?
You can't split shit in this game. Once you stack it, you're fucked. Literally.
And I like to use, like I said, I don't like beauty blenders anymore. I changed my ways.
My opinion is a little bit too hard.
I grew up. And I feel like this is a whole lot better and easier and faster. Because look how big this brush is. And the product's not being absorbed. It's right there, like, on the brush. And it, like, you know, you feel me? Like, it's not being taken away or sinked in or absorbed like a sponge usually does.
This guy was only level 6 they killed. The one with the hunter.
Okay. So then you guys already know what concealer I'm gonna go with. The L'Oreal Infallible Concealer. We're just gonna go a little bit in the corners.
I need to get the fuck out
of here. Yeah, we're gonna let that dry. Well, not dry, but sit a little bit. So we can get some good coverage. And you guys, this is like, I think this was like, I'm just gonna go with a higher price just in case of anything. But this was like $12, not really like 10, I think, or 9. And this was like 10, or like $9, or probably $10. Might be on the right. Or let me look it up. There are two different kinds of L'Oreal, the foundations. Oh, I guess there's the matte version and then the regular version. The regular version at Ulta, I don't know why, it retails for $14.99. But I got this at Walmart. So we're going to let that sit. But while we're letting it sit, I'm going to look for the prices for you guys, because I don't want to give you guys like the wrong prices. And y'all go over there on a budget and y'all just like, okay, checking out. Or I have the Walmart app, so we can do that. The L'Oreal Paris Infallible Foundation retails to $11.48. Foundation one, it retails for $10.97. So it's not bad. You just need a little bit, $25 with tax, depending how much your taxes is in your state. But you just need.
I need to stop playing
scared and
go for more loot.
On a budget. I got y'all. Now we're just going to go ahead and start dabbing it.
Yeah.
Just dab the concealer in there, like, you know, just dab, 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 dab. And then the edges, drag it out. Like, you know, kind of like a brush. Just drag it out like this. For contour, I'm about to show you guys. I used to use it as a foundation, but I ran out of it. And I, you know, went to the store and I was going to go buy it. But then they didn't have it in my shade. So I got something that I thought would be my foundation and it wasn't. So I now use it as for contour. And it's the Milani. It's foundation and a concealer all in one bottle. And it retails for $8.97 in Walmart. Like a little dab like that.
I'm saying. I know what I'm saying. You want to do customs or reserve?
And I'm going to get this little brush right here.
I hate onions. I hate them.
This is the translucent powder that I use. It's Maybelline and the shade Light 01. And I got this also from Walmart, and it retails for $5 pretty much. It's $4.98. I'm going with a flat brush to pick up the translucent powder. Just dab it on. And while that sets, we're gonna go with our Morphe contour palette, 8H. I don't know. I don't know. And we're gonna go with Donut. And I'm just gonna not, I'm gonna like, you know, with the eyeshadow, just dome. Pack it on. Not really so much.
You see the dome?
But just pack it on, and then I'm gonna, once I'm done, I kind of like blend, you know, out the
outers. Hey, do you outers. See the dome or not, though?
Get the thing.
Hey. Oh, there's the dome. Do you have the eating pipe is my question.
Now we're gonna go in with the thick skin. What I fucking need.
This guy is exactly who he says he is.
Under the eye right here.
A lot of it, you get that gut feeling about things, you know, when you know.
And my just gonna dump it on.
I've never had that guard go up. I'm 100% sure that he is who he says he is. Because, I mean, or else I would be...
Oh, bro, he had a key card on him, bro.
So you know what makes like snow be flirty, like, okay? He had a key card on. Yeah, and this one's like naked. Now that we're done with that, we're gonna spray our face. Iconic London. Drown in it. Learn how to put them swim today. I don't know how to swim. Just get a piece of paper. I got this whenever I ordered my concealers. I'm gonna use it for a thing. So guys, this is the completed look. I'll do like a slow motion video so you guys could see it. You guys can wear this makeup look, you know, it's something simple, but like, who is she? If you want to go shopping or something and you just want to have like a pop to it, this is it. And then with this shirt, it's like everything. Added some hoops on, yeah, you dig. Go ahead and comment because I'm telling you guys, when you guys comment, I really do appreciate that you guys are interacting with me, and it really does make me happy. Because it makes me feel like I'm doing something right. I know it might be a little bit too cliche or cheesy, but it's honestly true. And you guys, I just feel like posting another video. You know what I mean? Because you guys are just like, you know, oh, like, you know, she's on her shit. She can do this shit, and I just want to continue to do this to impress you guys. And just thank you guys so much for, you know, the support. I know it's not like I fucking got like 100,000 subscribers or anything like that. But the little, like, I didn't even think that I would even fucking have 50, past 50 subscribers, honestly. I think I only have 4 friends. So I only got 4 friends. And because, you know, keeping my circle small or whatever, it doesn't matter. And, you know, they're supportive. I love them. I really don't see my friends as my friends. I see them more as family. But that's why I didn't think that I would have, like, past 50 subscribers. And you guys, like, you know, did that. You guys, you know, yes, there was some negativity, but it's not dragging me down. And I'm not gonna let it drag me down for what? It's gonna keep pushing me. Because I feel like... the good is overcoming the bad, and not only that, if I let the bad get to me and drain me, I wouldn't have done this makeup look. That's why I'm saying thank you to you guys for the support and the comments, and it really hypes me up. Like, it really hypes a bitch up, you know, to feel cute, to get cute, even though I'm on quarantine. And sometimes, you know, my breathing may not be the best. I have my machine here. But now, it's getting better. I just have to do it every 4 hours, my machine. So, you know, being here in the room does kind of suck sometimes. Yeah, I have my man, you know, I have my makeup and everything here, but then you just want to go out sometimes and get cute to go do whatever, or just get cute sometimes. And why not do it and help others, you know, like on how or what tips and share techniques and stuff like that. Hope you guys really did like this video. Y'all leave a thumbs up. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this video towards the end. I really appreciate you. I love you guys. I love y'all as like my sisters, okay? Because you guys, that's what family does. They support. So leave a comment. Let me know what you guys think about this look. Where would you guys wear this look? You know, just let me know. And also just like let me know whatever kind of makeup looks you guys would like, share, and subscribe to this video. And yeah. See you guys. Bye.